The committee chairperson, Okori Moy, who doubles as the Abim district woman representative, noted that the country has been facing shortage of food, as seen during health emergencies occasioned by COVID-19 and Ebola lockdowns due to lack of clear approaches to ensure food security.
Before it goes to Ministry for Disaster Preparedness, how prepared are we as a ministry? What food production and food security arrangements do we have? Because we don't want this kind of ad hoc methods of handling things. Oh, you hear some Karimojong is stabbing in Madeniko. Let's run there with some soya beans and a plant. Somebody in Isingiro is stabbing. Okay, let's run with some maize also for them to plant. Why don't we have a strategy?
Legislators expressed with shock that while the year's budget strategy developed by the Minister of Finance hinged on food security as a key priority for agro-industrialization, no allocation was made for the purpose.
It seems there is zero money. Honorable Minister, on page 19, where you are planning to buy hoes for farmers, there is zero money in the available budget. There is nowhere you can guide this committee where we can make a cut. If possible, we can reduce on the tractor.
Right now, seasons have changed completely, so people are not harvesting enough food to even provide the value chain upwards. And apart from that, any country, the best resource you have is your human resource. People are hungry because there's very little food, and mostly because there's no water.
Uganda's main threats to food security include population growth, the increased demand for food, food prices, the disappearance of the variety of agricultural plant species, the increase in water scarcity, and the limitation of the availability of land, food losses, and food waste. Legislators observed that food insecurity is raging in the country because majority of local farmers are not being helped by the ministry to undertake proper post-harvesting.
Budget cannot have hoes out of it. They are Ugandans until they die, who will never have an acre of land, the whole family. At least those you hear, bakolera emere ya lero. Please don't disturb our minister. Honorable minister, these advisors of ours, they need to put this on.
However, Bright Ramirama, the Minister of State for Agriculture, responded that the government has rolled out the Parish Development Model Program as the epicenter of multi-sectoral community development.
Chairperson, honorable members, colleagues, as you have seen from the Agricultural Value Chain Development Strategy and HE, the President's Policy Directive on Agro-Industrialization, every activity prioritized will be contributing to alleviating constraints for the farmers to each value chain stage. A holistic planning and integration of all stages of different commodity value chain is required.
We as in government, including all of us here, sometimes we bat our head on the sand. We know the government has a limited resource, but we want to touch everywhere. Why don't we, as members of this committee, with the Minister of Agriculture, say for the next few years we are going to do 1, 2, 3. And we stop this politics of fooling ourselves. Because
the project budget for the ministry's agro-industrialization program in the financial year 2023-2024 is 1.499 trillion shillings out of the 49.9 trillion shillings to cover strategic interventions including disease control, mechanization, and civil works, among others. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.